the desire to take flight appears to be hardwired to humanity's DNA. Modern aviation has come a long way from the failed attempts of Icarus. Philippine Aviation has kept abreast with these advancements, and the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAAP, has helped propel the industry to be among the best in the world.
The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or the CAAP, is the aviation safety oversight mechanism of the Republic of the Philippines. The role of CAAP really in our society is to see to it that the airlines, our civil aviation industry here, is operated in accordance with international civil aviation standards.
Legislative Act No. 3909, passed by Congress in November 20, 1931, gave birth to a body under the Department of Commerce and Communication. This body was tasked to handle a variety of aviation matters.
It started as the Civil Aeronautics Administration in the 50s. You know. Then it became the Bureau of Air Transportation, then the Air Transportation Office, all under the DOTC. And then the FAA came here, and the ACAO as well, and said that maybe this is not in accordance with international standards, because ideal is to have a civil aviation authority that is autonomous, that can do its function of regulating so that our airlines will be flying safely, so that we can manage the airspace that we have above us, so that air travel airplanes can fly in a safe, secure manner.
Even during times of uncertainty, what was then known as the Civil Aeronautics Administration continued to be a beacon for the aviation industry. In March of 1978, the Civil Aviation's Training Center was instituted. The CATC became more than the CAAP's training arm. It became a standard of excellence in the region.
That was one of the among probably the best in the Asian region at the time, as far as coming up with aviation professionals is concerned. Training the traffic controllers, training the air navigation engineers, meaning say the guys that take care of the navigational instruments.
On December 3, 2007, then-Senator Edgardo Angara filed a bill to abolish the ATO and the creation of the Civil Aviation Authority. On March 4, 2008, the bill was signed into law. The latest incarnation of the aviation industry's now independent regulatory body is now expanding the horizons for Philippine aviation.
The law that created the CAAP set up a fiscally autonomous entity, meaning to say before the ATO got its budget from the national government, today, with fiscal autonomy, and the Civil Aviation Authority, from the fees that it collects from overflights of international airlines over our airspace, and landing and takeoff fees, and other fees as well, including terminal fees in the airports that we manage. The funds that we get, we collect, and we spend for our requirements, the salaries of our people, development of the airports that we manage, and more especially training of the inspectors that we are supposed to have. These are the guys who really go out into the field, look at airplanes and see to it that they're airworthy, go to the airlines and see to it that the airlines are operated safely, inspect the buildings near the airports to see to it that they are of a certain height only, so that they will not restrict the vision of the control tower.
But it wasn't always smooth sailing for local aviation. The industry went through turbulent skies. In 2008, the United States Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, downgraded the country's ratings from Category 1 to 2. And in 2010, the European Union banned Philippine carriers from flying within European airspace.
The ICAO came over and declared that the ATO then
had significant safety concerns. As a regulatory body, we're all covered by the Chicago Convention, heard in November 1944, wherein we are signatories to this, which means we have to abide by minimum safety standards of the ICAO. The ICAO audited us, and they found several deficiencies, which they termed as significant safety concerns. Because of this, the FAA followed suit, conducted their own audit, and confirmed the findings, and placed us in Category 2. We had what you call a black eye in the international community.
Yes.
We had the status of a country being banned, and there's, of course, economic implications as far as this is concerned. Mm-hmm. Now, to get this back was quite a job for us to do.
But Philippine Aviation rose from these setbacks. In June of this year, the EU did a safety assessment visit. In the following month, the US FAA also made its own assessment visit. In July 12, the CAAP was cleared by the EU, and Philippine Airlines can now enter European airspace. Philippine Airlines will now be expanding its flights to London, Rome, Frankfurt, and Amsterdam. The CAAP is also targeting to regain its Category 1 rating from the FAA before the year ends. More open skies would boost the 4.2 million tourists that flocked to the country last year.
We were given marching orders by the president. And in some instances, some interviews that we had, we were in fact called as the retirables. But these retirables were able to produce. That means that if there is unity and there is purpose, especially in the team that was created, we will achieve the results that people believe could not be done in this short time. We had to overhaul the whole system and institute reforms. We got everybody in the picture, acting as a whole body, and we were able to address the significant safety concerns. Once this was done, the next step would be to get the lifting of the EU ban.
As the Philippine aviation industry rides the momentum of these victories, the Flight Standard and Inspectorate Service, or FSIS, ensures the safe conduct of all aviation activities happening within the country's airspace. The FSIS aims to be near the top in flight standard service in Asia.
Its core function is really to regulate and supervise the airmen, operators, and the maintenance of the aircraft. This is the very core of CAAP's regulatory function, because it is the service which is in charge of regulating the aviation industry. Our role in a proactive way is to, before anything else happens or before anything happens, that we are actively exercising our oversight function over the industry.
Also ensuring the safety of Philippine airspace by directing traffic above is the air traffic service arm of the CAAP.
They're the ones who control all commercial aviation traffic in the Philippines. The safe management of traffic, whether it is landing any part of the Philippines or overflying within our FIR.
With all the competent CAAP personnel ensuring a safe, secure, and green Philippine sky, state-of-the-art navigation aids are a huge complement. Most of these aids, like the instrument landing system and the distance measuring equipment, ensure a safe landing in any weather condition.
5 to 10 years from now, if we can sustain the reforms that we have done so far and modernize our equipment, get our information technology systems up to par, then I would believe that we'll become a preeminent civil aviation authority and compare ourselves even with the FAA.
The bright future of air aviation in the country is more than just a pipe dream. The CAAP is now on the verge of setting the bar higher for global aviation standards.
We are coming up with what we call the PASA, Philippine Aviation Safety Assessment, or Audit Standards, our own standards. because that is what actually the FAA and the European Union is doing. They set standards a bit higher than the international standards of ICAO and require the airlines that are flying into their territory to really approach those standards.
We are going to be world standard, and including the aviation industry. This CAP team does not only use safety as a byword, but safety for us is a prevention. It is going to be a very proactive approach that we are going to be using. And we're going to be instituting national regulations that may not even be envisioned by ICAO.
The future is in the skies.